but oh, that's funny. He's too funny for an hour. But everybody's funny for a half hour.
Good friends Gary Sandling and Brian Benben, stars of the best hour of comedy on TV.
Brian is a fine actor, and I'm a big fan.
He's a funny guy. Really very funny.
I'll tell you something about Brian. Calls me up like 1, 2 in the morning, hangs up.
He was a neighbor of mine for a while, Gary was. Yeah, he was. Nobody liked him.
Yeah, just calls me up, I go, hello. Hangs up. We're putting a tracer on it. I'm sure it's Brian.
He used to drive by in very expensive cars once in a while. He'd wave about, you know, maybe half the time.
I'll tell you what Brian is doing. He's paying somebody to call me and hang up just so I... This is all off the record.
He's a nice guy, though. Funny. Good, talented. Funny guy. Very funny.
Larry Sanders and Dream On, both halves of the best hour of comedy on TV. An all-new season premieres Wednesday night, June 22nd at 10, only on HBO.
For her fans, the much-awaited release of a new Bonnie Raitt LP has come just in the nick of time. The record, her 12th, is called Longing in Their Hearts. As usual, Raitt pulls on the heartstrings of her listeners with songs like Love Sneaking Up on You.
I'm one of those people that can't really write when there's a lot of distractions. So I'm listening to tapes. You know, I get lots and lots of tapes sent with songs that are supposedly really perfect for me. And that's how I find great stuff. It's kind of like fishing, you know. You just have to wade through a lot of stuff and finally you get something that bites. Don't worry, baby. There ain't nothing new. That's just love sneaking up on you.
Bonnie Raitt started her professional music career following in the footsteps of her father, John Raitt, in the early 70s. After years of moderate success on the nightclub circuit, Raitt finally hit it big with the release of her 10th LP, Nick of Time. The LP featured songs like Thing Called Love and Love Letter, and garnered Raitt 3 Grammy Awards. She admits the recognition, which to many seemed long overdue, meant a lot.
And at the time, this was something that was really meaningful, as was the fact that the record had gotten a really good response even in the year before that. This was just icing on the cake, but you know, it catapulted me into a level of success that even I couldn't have dreamed of.
Raitt's luck continued in 1991 with the release of her follow-up LP, Luck of the Draw, which added 3 more Grammys to her collection. Despite the awards, Raitt says she owes it all to her fans.
You know, I wasn't really ever that scuffling. You know, I was always doing gigs, drawing really well in the markets that I do well in, and my fans never turned their back on me. I didn't turn my back on them. I was always on tour, and I just think it gets... I don't know if it's glamorized, but sensationalized a little bit, because it's, you know, it's like winning the lottery. I mean, I really became so well known suddenly overnight because of this relative obscurity that I had, which doesn't mean I wasn't successful. It just means that I had a cult loyal cult following, which to me was great and still is. Let's really show it, darling. Being on the front page of the paper made me a news item all over the world, and suddenly, you know, people bought my records because they were curious, and thank God they liked them because they liked the next record afterwards, so I guess it wasn't a fluke.
So with all this success and personal happiness, Bonnie Raitt seems to have no worries.
What I care about is doing really great work that shows a lot of growth and risk-taking, and, you know, I'm playing for my peers and my pals, you know, the other musicians that I really admire. And when they call me up and say, you know, your record's really slamming, you did another great job, I mean, that's what I'm waiting to hear.
Next on HBO.
When the court awards the custody of a mother's child to its abusive father, Veronica Hamill steps in to keep the child safe, and she'll stop at nothing.
Next on HBO.
The Widow.
Somewhere in Mississippi lives the man who murdered my husband.
The Murderer.
There's a lot in the Bible about niggers, but it don't call them niggers, it calls them beasts.
It took her 30 years.
When he called us beasts, when he said that we had no heart, no mind, no soul.
I believe in extermination.
And three trials.
When I want to know something from a nigger, I tell the nigger to come to me.
The word nigger, still does something to me.
To finally bring him to justice.
This man is guilty of murdering my husband.
An America Undercover special, Southern Justice, The Murder of Medgar Evers, coming in July, only on HBO.
Yes, Medgar, yes!
It's never too late for justice.
Every month, real life kids, real life problems, real life stories. Calvin Meir always dreamed of being an altar boy.
I used to pray that something like this would happen to me.
What do you have to do?
I don't know. Guess you just do what Father says.
He never imagined his dream would turn into a nightmare.
I know what you're doing at church.
Oh, you're going to the rectory of Father's
life. Father, shut up!
Or that the person he trusted most would betray him.
Calvin, he's a priest. He can do what he wants. We're the ones who will get blamed.
Did you do something that you're not telling me?
A Child Betrayed, the Calvin Meir story.
I don't want to be an old boy anymore.
Every kid's got a story, but not always one he wants to tell. Life stories, families in crisis. Premieres Tuesday, June 7th on HBO. Are you ready to listen?
Tonight, it's on HBO. At 8, everybody wants it, everybody needs it. Damon and Marlon Wayans, Mo Money. At 9:30, HBO's own sexy, funny, adults-only Dream On. And at 10, the last word on the week that was, the groundbreaking new series, Dennis Miller. Mo Money, Dream On, and Dennis Miller. HBO is on tonight.
For one given to eccentric or lunatic ideas, originally meant crazy in the head. Susan.
What is crackpot?
Crackpot is right.
Let's try...